It is my proud pleasure that I have been here amongst this distinguished audience. And first of all, I would like to pay my heartily thanks to the organizers, especially Dr. Hari Om Vats. The topic of my work, which I am going to present over here, is: are the traces of life and intelligence hidden in the deep sky? I am Neeraj Chaubey from KNIT Sultanpur, which is run by the state government of Uttar Pradesh. Now, what I want to remember amongst all of you, that Dr. Albert Einstein himself once told that the most profound beauty and emotion one can experience is the sensation of mystical. One who is no longer surprised over the beauty of the nature, one who stands rapt over the beauty of nature, is as good as dead. So this is a mystical which we want to investigate every time. And now this is a mystical, that whether the life has any rooting in sky, in the deep sky, or it has been created only for the purpose of this planet Earth. Before I proceed further, I would like to lay out the horizons for such a study. First is a life phenomena. Second, we want to look into a spectacular panorama, the terrestrial biology. Thereafter, the stellar background. And then the evidence for interstellar biochemicals. We will like to see the possible clues, and then Earth in the solar system as our home. We would like to explore the sites in the universe where the life and intelligence may be possible, and communication with the other possible civilizations as far as possible. We know the life forms, but first we would like to define, to think over what is life. If the matter attains the property of reproducing itself, the matter is said to have life. We know the life forms as we see everywhere on our home planet, the Earth. But a very natural question arises as to how and from which place the life might be initiated. The belief, as also in Darwinism, is that the life was originated on Earth itself, which got gradually advanced to come up in the present day form. But most spectacular finding by astrophysicists is that the life was originated far away from the Earth in the intergalactic space in its dark matter. Now we would like to see the basic life forms. Whatever has been found in this new subject of exobiology, what type of forms have been seen which instigate us to think over further. A strange fact is that such life forms, due to certain carbonaceous compounds, have been in the dormant stage of prebiotic molecules. Such prebiotic molecules, which are at the threshold to create life, seemingly already present in the intergalactic space, usually come to solar system due to comets, which take one round after 76 years or so. Professor Fred Hoyle and N.C. Vikram Singhe and others have found that such prebiotic molecules are spread over at the time of transition of each comet in our solar system, wherein gravity plays a gallant role. I am showing this basic life form, the prebiotic molecules, and this is a picture taken in 2017, has been in the file of NASA, and this is the first very most initial, the most primitive form where the life begins. The idea that the whole universe life is unique to Earth is essentially pre-Copernican. Experience has now repeatedly taught us that the reality is far from this idea. Why should our own infinitesimal niche in the universe be unique? Just as no country can be the center of the Earth, so the Earth is not the center of universe. Astronomy is involved in the origin of life at the level of complex biomolecules, particularly the chains of sugar molecules linked through the hydrogen polysaccharides. At a most rudimentary chemical level, the life in all its varied shapes and forms simply involves interaction between the nucleic acids and proteins. I am showing you the species detected with the GPT towards Sagittarius B2N. These species are with the different colors to indicate their different joints and their valency also. Nucleic acids are constructed of one sugar, four bases, adenine, guanine, thymine, and cytosine, and a phosphate. Protein contains about 21 amino acids. The myriads of possible arrangements and rearrangements of these 27 or so basic substructures make up the wide diversity of the life forms in our planet. Evolution, mutation, and adaptation provide causal links from the simplest microbe to the highest form of animal life. But what could be said to the very first microbe, origin of life, if it took place on Earth, was a unique and a singular event. Yet, this original event is concealed in the tinder box of mystery. Due to certain congenial circumstances prevailing on the Earth, they infect the Earth and after certain stages come in the elementary life form. It is also now not to be believed as such that DNA and RNA are abstracts of life. Life may also be present in some other forms which may be matter of present day investigations. Features to it along with possible sites have been exhibited so that interest is created in the researches in this new science which is known as exobiology. Before we rush into the exobiological investigations, I would like to provide you the preliminary concepts of astronomy. So here is the Hertzsprung-Russell diagram of stars, which indicates that stars also have the life. They take birth, they become young, they become more young, they become old, and ultimately they die. Moreover, because of Earth is located in Milky Way, I would like to show the Milky Way galaxy in its end-on and face-on view. The cross is indicated to tell you about the location of Sun in this Milky Way galaxy. Investigations have now compelled to ponder over a totally different point of view concerning the origin of prebiotic molecules and also of life. This point of view is sure to turn out to integrate life into a wider astronomical background. Evidences exhibit that the evolution of life on Earth has continued for at least 3 billion years. The figure forthcoming shows a time scale for cosmic events and evolution of life on Earth. Now in this figure, time is indicated in million years. And so from the beginning, from evolution of man, then these mammals appear, etc. Starting is from Big Bang. From Big Bang, galaxy formation, then oldest stars in our galaxy, they are formed at near about 10,000, then 6,000, and 6,000 is formation of sun from the gas clouds. Thereafter, microfossils, biological evolution, and evolution of man. The most recent fossil record up to about 600 million years ago is the Batter document. The earliest primates appeared on the Earth at some rather its defined moment about 65 million years ago. The earliest tangible evidence for a terrestrial life dates back 3.1 billion years to the Fig tree chart. This, however, almost certainly cannot represent the ultimate origin. The evolution of primitive life forms out of some sort of prebiotic material might have taken place between 4.5 and 3.1 billion years ago. I am showing the life forms on geological record, where this BP indicates the before present and now means today's situation. MA is short form for million age, and here I have shown the evolution both in terms of plants as well as the animals, both the zoological and botanical. So much for the evolution in action reckoned on geological time scales, but biological evolution is of course an inexorably continuing process. And during the 20 years of Darwin's original observations, evidence for evolution in certain species became manifest. Life is based on the very fundamental but all pervasive architecture of the cell. Again and again I would like to recall that the life is defined as the property of self-replication. Unless and until this property is created in matter, we don't say that matter is living. The physical and chemical makeup of cells will have an important bearing on the arrangement for the extraterrestrial origin of living things within our direct or indirect experience. Now, I am presenting before you the relative abundance by mass of elements which I have adopted from M. Coleman, Oxford, 1969. Here the elements are listed in the first column like hydrogen, helium, oxygen, carbon and so on. Cosmos relative abundances are indicated like 1,278, 11.8 and so on. For Earth, we have bifurcated in two forms, atmosphere and hydrosphere. Then hydrogen is 2.0, helium is 9.978, etc. And on crust, it is 0.03 and 0.623, etc. For life, the plant percent and animal percent are indicated. It is 10.79 here. For animals, it is 10.65, 18. as starch and cellulose are the most common polysaccharides. The formation of a polysaccharide chain by joining together of glucose molecules involves the liberation of a molecule of water. Further, cellulose forms a major component of cell walls in plants. It is overwhelming dominance of terrestrial biology. It is not only most abundant on the earth, but also to be by far the most abundant organic substance throughout the galaxy. The same cellulose, tar-like substance, has been found in the interstellar space. Now is the evolution of stars with HR diagram. This is evolution of stars of 1 to 10 solar masses on the HR diagram, treating solar mass to be 1. And 10 solar mass means 10 solar masses with the particular symbol. The indication, which is from the straight line on its outside, these indicators, they are all the terrestrial forms which provide the biological links. Apart from polysaccharides, there are other basic elements made up of sugar ribose for RNA, deoxyribose for DNA. DNA, RNA are made up of a sugar, a phosphate, and four bases. Adenine, indicated by capital A, thymine by capital T, guanine by capital G, cytosine by capital C. For RNA, the uracil replaces the thymine. DNA always exists as a double-stranded molecule. A single DNA strand may also be represented by the upper half of the rail track extended into a very long chain, with each of tie being at one of the permitted pairings AT, TA, GC, CG. Its pattern holds all the information. In real life, this long track is neither straight nor in one plane, but it is twisted into a double helix. It is depiction of the fact. The rail track segment of DNA is indicated above, and this AT or say TA, all these bindings have been seen. Twisted ribbon model for DNA, the double helix, is indicated below. And this twisted ribbon model of DNA, double helix, showing arrangements of molecular units on it. The entire structure is coiled up and occupies a very small volume of the cell nucleus. DNA strands are divided into many small segments known as chromosomes, of which there are 23 pairs in the human cells. If the number of pairs are changed, the human being will change to another animal. RNA molecules, which are of three main types, the messenger RNA, indicated as a small mRNA, ribosomal RNA, indicated as a small rRNA, and transfer RNA, indicated as tRNA, are single-stranded molecules, except that sugar is replaced by ribose and thymine by uracil. Besides, enzymes and chlorophyll, with the crucial importance for origin of life, here one thing is very important. Enzymes in the case of animals and chlorophyll is for plants. These basic chemicals of life appear in terrestrial life forms and they provide the crucial links in the search of origin of life. As such, low densities and temperatures, interstellar atoms move slowly and interact with one another rather sluggishly. But a long time scales, which are available 1 million to 100 million years for a lifetime to a lifetime of clouds allowing a chemistry to develop. This type of chemistry, known as ion molecule chemistry, was first developed in astronomical context by P. M. Solomon and N. C. Vikram Singh in 1970. Radio astronomers have recently discovered a wide range of molecule species in clouds, which are probably at just about the stage of collapse. Now is the list of interstellar molecules. The observed interstellar molecules have been shown classified in two forms, the inorganic and organic. Thereafter, inorganic list like H2, OH, etc., hydroxyl, and organic like, say, CH, CH+. These are again divided into diatomic, triatomic, four atomic, five atomic, etc., and so on. So, it's a detailed list of interstellar molecules. The grains so formed collide sufficiently often to produce larger grains. Such composite dust grains contain a hybrid mixture of many organic materials. The Orion Nebula is a spectacular example for the region of galaxy where stars are forming at present time. Normally, the nebula is the place where stars take birth. So, all the plasma and other gas which is utilized in the formation of new stars, it leaves some matter which is in the millions of the years in the situation to create a chemistry for life. The Orion Nebula, this is depicted, all its hot spots are there, so the remaining part which is spread over, this is having the sluggish matter which ultimately gets the property of life to become life. It is therefore only the part of gas in space that goes towards the formation of stars. The rest of the gas being subject to a complex of prebiotic chemistry in which the basic material of life are formed. Organic carbon in an ordinary chondritic meteorite obtained during a scanning transmission X-ray microscope at the Advanced Light Source, Lawrence Berkeley Laboratory. The sample was obtained using a focused ion beam electron microscope, which is shortly written like MILL. In this image, carbon is highlighted in red, iron in blue, and calcium is green. The history of early solar system is recorded in the molecular structure of extraterrestrial organic solids, and the same is evidently manifest in the forthcoming picture. This is evidences of extraterrestrial life found in Earth's atmosphere. In a research paper called "The Fossil Diatoms in a New Carboniferous Meteorite that appeared in Controversia, Journal of Cosmology," and Vikram Singh claimed to have found a strong evidence that life exists throughout the universe based on his study of the reported remains of large meteorites. For that, you can go through this image that fell near Sri Lanka village Polonnaruwa on December 29, 2012. Vikram Singhe and the late English astronomer Fred Hoyle co-developed a theory known as panspermia, which suggests that the life exists throughout the universe and is distributed by meteoroids and asteroids. NASA finds extraterrestrial amino acids in Sudan meteorites. The photograph of the same is being presented over here. These are certain significant star forming regions where the life elements of life forms are also quite in abundance and may be formed in 1 million years or so. The most dramatic of the discoveries in infrared astronomy was made by E.P. Dain, W.A. Stein, J.E. Goddard, F.C. Gillett and R.F. Crack in 1969 that a broadband spectral features were found in 8 to 12 micron wave band appeared in the emission of the spectra of several oxygen-rich supergiant stars, such is the depiction. This is spectra of the cool oxygen-rich stars. Moreover, cellulose was found to be free of unwanted bands. Hoyle and Vikram Singh verified that cellulose can account both for 8 to 12 micron emission feature and for the 18 micron band in the observed spectrum of a trapezium nebula. This is analogy of a normal distribution curve. In 2200 angstrom, 4.6 inverse micrometer band due perhaps to organic inorganic ring compounds with the formula C8H12N2 compared with the astronomical data on the absorption of the starlight. Reciprocal wavelength is in the form of inverse micrometer while extinction of the stars are indicated on Y side. What is most important to see that there are certain spots which are also created. They have their skew and also kurtosis. At a certain stage, we can think that this is quite in analogy to the normal distribution curve, and to some extent, it can be shifted to the normal distribution if asymptotic character is obtained. This close agreement convinces that the interstellar dust consists chiefly of cellulose or of some related polysaccharide further together with AH olefin. This subsequently obtained laboratory data of the same providing a close fit to a wide range of observed astronomical infrared sources. Same is depicted in this picture. It is intensity versus wavelength of observed infrared radiations from astronomical sources, and again it is quite in agreement between observed infrared radiations from astronomical sources and cellulose models. Means one thing is on the part of astrophysics, which is quite in agreement with the life scientific basis. Both are quite agreeing with each other, indicating that the source is in the faraway place of astronomical regions in the sky. Next. The presence of at least two organic molecules, the methyl cyanide and hydrogen cyanide. These were also inferred from radio astronomical observations of the comet Kohoutek. Also, there is an impressive list of atoms, ions and molecules which have been detected in comets. It also provides the clues and explorations, which is one of the seventh point of our investigation. Atomic and molecular species in the comets are shown. These are atoms, then radicals, ions and simple molecules, then organic molecules and also the dust. These are classified over. They provide the clues and explorations of life forms in space. It is a picture of a comet. As is indicated, its head is on the tip point and the remaining the colored point, which is far away. These are radiations emanating from it. While crossing the sun, it leaves those traces which it is bringing from such a long distance of intergalactic space, and these are those prebiotic molecules where the life is in the slept form. It is sporadic throughout the solar system, but at Earth they get some congenial atmosphere to create the life in its physical shape. This is other nearby stars which seem to have planets. This is listed along with their distance, the mass of a star, treating the mass of Sun as unity, and the mass of planets where Jupiter is taken to be unity, and their orbital periods in the years have also been indicated. So on these, the chances for having life are much more. The nearest stars more likely to have habitable planets, so these are listed like these stars are Alpha Centauri, Alpha Centauri B, Epsilon Eridani, etc. And their distance from Earth in light years is a little distance, 4.3, 10.8, 12.2, etc. This is indicative region, which indicates as to how these stars are not only formed. Astronomical coincidences take place, but also the biological existence starts after a very long sluggish formation. This illustration shows how newly discovered organic compounds, the ingredients of amino acids, were detected by NASA's Cassini spacecraft in the ice grains emitted from Saturn's moon Enceladus. Powerful hydrothermal vents eject material from Enceladus core into the moon's massive subsurface ocean. After mixing with the water, the material is released into space as water vapor and ice grains. This is a picture showing the jet spews in Enceladus, and this is indicating as to how the water vapor, this is from the surface. But the most unfortunate part is that in the year of 2018 on 17th March, when the Cassini aircraft was sending its pictures, some photographs were really indicating some existence of life, both in botanical and animal form. It was expected that below the ice the life was there. But at that stage, it stopped sending the photographs because its battery was over. And it was most unfortunate on the part of human being that most material information regarding life was lost. And we were deprived of that. Condensed onto the ice grains are the nitrogen and oxygen bearing organic compounds. On Earth, hydrothermal vents on the ocean floor provide the energy that fuels reactions that produce amino acids, the building blocks of life. Scientists believe Enceladus hydrothermal vents may operate in the same way, supplying energy that leads to the production of amino acids. In 2006, I have myself gone through the implications of newly invented observables Q and QN on the life-bearing spots in the universe, wherein the time-varying gravity concept, which is studied by myself in 2005, has been made in context of Frank Drake formulation in the light of a formula that number of technologies is equal to the number of habitable planets multiplied by technological life span divided by main sequence life of a star. At this stage, I would like to make clear that civilization is due to the index of technology. Higher the index of technology, the society is said to be more civilized. And that relates to the number of habitable planets. So this technology has been created in the form of this. Further investigations are according to as being in Yusuf Suchu Nuri Urai in 2 plus 1 dimensional gravity, published in 2007 in the Journal of Mathematical Physics, and also by Jan Verbeek 2007, the Kepler problem with time-dependent and resonant perturbations, published in the Journal of Mathematical Physics in 2007. These may also provide the basis for the same. Neeraj Chaubey and Alka Mishra 2012 have investigated certain contrivances towards the instantaneous perception of extraterrestrial life and intelligence by way of cloud computing. Special thanks are due to Dr. Alka Mishra, the Department of Mathematics and Astronomy, Lucknow University, for her most valuable and unforgettable help and contribution. Certain references which can make you to proceed in the subject and also to rush into that, it is listed over here. Thank you. Yes.